Hi again and welcome back. In this video, we're going to actually dive into the valleys of attachment a little bit more. So hang on. Let's look at the next slide and kind of lead in there from that valley, right? We're talking about what might disrupt that parent or that caregiver and home visitor or therapist relationship, but even what disrupts the relationships from the child's perspective. What might cause, we talked about those adaptive attachments, because children tend to internalize, right? You spoke earlier about those sensory, as an infant, those sensory experiences. What children, experienced, what they've missed maybe, they internalize them and hold on to them. You've talked about that before. So the smell of mom might be the smell of food. It might be the feeling, the touch, the lotion being rubbed on my body. And I feel so safe and secure and it's healing. And you talked about the importance, especially in the Black culture, of hair brushing and hair styles, right? And doing your hair.
Yeah, that whole grooming piece. Yeah, that whole grooming piece can be missed. And you know, when we looked at this information, Roxana, we were also looking at it from kind of the displaced child, right? The child who may have been bounced around several times. And so being able to form that secure attachment with one healthy adult has really been hard because they've moved so much. And so many times as adults, we will take for granted the missed or misattunement. Am I saying this right?
Yeah, misattunement.
The missed things that a child really values. And so for the adult, it's misattunement.
There you go.
Fix it. Okay.
Yep, that's right.
So what you were talking about was, and so my mom is a licensed foster parent. And a lot of times, you know, she'll have children for a long season. And there will come a time, and maybe it's later on within the relationship, that they have an opportunity to, you know, connect and see their parent or what have you. And my mom's really, you know, poured into this child in so many different ways. And they go and they see mom or dad or someone from their family, and they get this little trinket. And they are holding on to that little trinket for dear life. And my mom is just like, you would have thought that, you know, that caregiver had bought them a brand new Mercedes. And it is those moments of misattunement that we don't recognize that there is still an attachment, some sort, whether it is secure or adaptive, that child has with that primary caregiver, right?
Yeah.
And that this new primary caregiver has an opportunity to build their own with this child. And so I kind of digressed where I was going, but I do want us to remember that there are routines and smells and sounds and things of that nature that sometimes we are not attuned to. It relates to how children begin to connect with other people. Remember, yeah. We talked about having that capacity to have multiple people in their attachment circle. So what we need to do, the purpose of this whole conversation here, is that as caregivers, remember, we're not going to always get to the peak, the mountain peak. We're not going to always get to the highest point and feel perfect. And that's absolutely okay, because research has shown, and we know it in our hearts, that if we could just get it right half the time.
50% of the time, right?
If we could just get it right half the time, that the child has the opportunity to build a healthy attachment.
Yeah.
It's okay. It is absolutely okay. Peaches and Roxanna are telling you today, it is absolutely okay not to be a perfect parent, a perfect caregiver, a perfect counselor or therapist. It is okay to be good enough.
Yeah.
You are good enough for someone.